action, though. Josh Kelly taking on Houston Campos. And Josh Kelly, pretty boy, 9-0-1. Tell you this. Yeah, his last fight was that fairly tentative of...
No, that Robinson, up here. That Robinson fight was a fight behind the jab. Look for the right shots. Not trying to find, not trying to look for the opening, just wait for the opening within yourself.
It's just so flashy, sir. It just looks so cool. The hands are back. And down goes Kelly here. No knock down, you okay? Behind the hands here. Cotton here, both his left and right eye. The rock is about. And with 20 seconds left in round one, he's already cut on the right eye. Campos knows it.
And here's what could have been a knockdown, but Raul Calle Jr. doing the right call. He hooked him.
Well, champion David Hay, a left and a right there. He's got pressure now on Campos.
Now, that's very impressive. And not for nothing,
Campos in the blue. He's trying to wrestle back some momentum after that first round.
Let me in the head, Josh. Let me in the
head. Campos is stablemates with just this round.
10 seconds. 10 segundos.
Nice uppercut there. And Campos on the ropes. Campos doesn't need survive. And here Kelly puts up the defense and trades a few punches here with Campos. Good action here. With a minute 18 left in round three.
Two. Pro Latino crowd here.
Yeah, and Kelly is cut once again when you see on this right eye.
And here we're going to see Campos get Kelly against the ropes. Kelly is such a smooth boxer. He does not want to be against the ropes, even though he can hold his own there. Campos is just getting the opportunity to unleash shots,
by the way, on Kelly underneath his left rib cage. This is a guy who is an outstanding amateur.
Box.
Including with that main event.
Oh, that hand right there by Kelly. Almost caught Campos coming in, and he's going back to what he is. Josh Kelly. This is what makes him fluid and but it's so tricky fighting southpaws. You need to find that opening. And Campos doesn't really fight like a southpaw. He's an aggressive southpaw. He backs up, timing in the distance. But it keeps you touching something and getting comfortable.
No, he did this.
Good body shots there by Kelly. Both sides.
1 minute left in round five. And some good exchanges here as Campos hit with the left and the right. Kelly's now coming back as well. Some good body punching from Campos.
Upping them arms a little bit. He's still in and out too.
And in a vulnerable position, dropping the hands, going. He's able to walk away without making any damage.
Kelly is not setting up with body shots right now. He's not setting up body shots. He's powering you speed to create the openings. Especially with a cage that you gotta use. And of course, the jab. Usually when you deal with an orthodox fighter, there's a lot of fouls, a lot of dirty tactics. That's just what happened. That's the name of
2013.
Sure, that sparring, that experience prepared him for another Olympian like Campos. Comfortably ahead, now he is. Yeah, of course he's looking for the win, but he's comfortable. It's also a moral victory going the distance.
He's not just going to become erratic and too loose, although, man, Kelly's doing some work now as he's got the right eye of Kelly, but he's shown his ability to box without many cuts. With 15 seconds left, he's got Campos on the left, trying to do some work here in the corner.
But Campos still looking for the hard counter shots. See those winging shots by Campos? Kelly bending his knees just to try to land that overhand right. And it's the fact that he made himself small to spring up that caught Campos off guard like that. Because Kelly was winging away, but that dip down made Campos believe that he was going to go to the body, and then he came up with an overhand right. See, hard shots usually don't land if you're just throwing shot after shot after shot. That's hard. But if you sneak in a hard shot with some sneakiness like that, just...
Winner by unanimous decision, he's still undefeated, Josh Pretty Boy Kelly.
Congrats to Josh Kelly, the winner by unanimous decision. Two of the judges said it 99-90, the other judge had it 98-91, so that is a... All right, tail the tape here. Liam Smith and Roberto Garcia will keep the UK theme going as Beefy will be fighting next. Lee beats Winston Campos. Now we got Liam Smith and Roberto Garcia. Garcia.
Back up. Punch is thrown to the body, to the head, but I expect Garcia to be the aggressor. He's the one we just saw a fight that we saw a lot of dirty tech.
And hitting him to the body. So we'll see if he applies that pressure and how much he attacks Liam Smith as he goes to the body.
Body shot right there by Smith, and then chopping down.
Four with 25 knockouts. He's been knocked down in the first round twice. To go. Smith crushed his countryman 24
like Antonio Margarito. You don't go to the head, you go to the body. And here's the combination I was talking about earlier. He went downstairs to the body, which was a beautiful shot, but did not forget about the head. Came in with a straight right hand. Smith did. Yeah, they want more left hooks to the body. That's what I was talking about.
Green line. Yeah, horse 9-11. Is that your car? Or is it horse Panamera? I forget.
Yeah, just, yeah, you know what? I'm thinking about buying a Porsche. Expect a trifecta of demise here on Smith. It's going to go left hook to the body, left hook to the head, and we're going to just beat him around.
Made about Smith with the uppercut. You saw it again just there. Whenever he can feel Garcia coming, he'll.
But you can already see his legs aren't there. He wants to get on the inside of Smith. Smith doing the right thing, keeping him on the outside. Heavy breath. So if Smith continues to fight on the outside, the tough Garcia.
Smith with a couple of strong lefts to the body of Garcia.
Here, Garcia doing what the shorter fighter normally wants to do is get on the inside. Smith doing the right thing, keeping him on the outside. That right uppercut.
And when Roberto's mother, Antonio, threatened to divorce him in 1990, his father shot her fatally through the chest in their bedroom and then turned the gun on himself. But out of all of that misery and pain, it's great to see him here at Talking Stick Resort Arena.
Good jab right there to the body by Smith. Chopping down, chopping Garcia in the middle. Good counter by Garcia right there in a southpaw stance. Easier said than done, but right here he's had some good shots against Smith.
This third round, Liam Smith is. Although then you may open yourself up a little bit. You saw Garcia with that good counter punch.
Yeah, but jabbing upstairs and not forgetting the jab downstairs. Beautiful body shot right there by Garcia. That hurt Garcia.
Right on the line.
Smith is definitely going with that left to the body.
Garcia's hurt to the body right now. You can see him trying to overcover that right side of his body. Well, that's going to hurt him. You see Garcia breathing. But still coming forward, showing grit.
He's missing with a couple of those rights. His eyebrows like, what? What do you want to say to me?
Now, Garcia's a tough guy, and I like the fact that he did that. The referee warning.
Yeah, absolutely. Right after the bell rang, referee to come in there quickly. Those guys want to throw.
And here we see that body shot that I saw that shot right there. Garcia lowered his right elbow right there. That was a vicious shot by Beefy Smith. But then you get Garcia with a dirty tackle. It's a blatant headbutt right there. And that was frustrating, the aggression of Garcia.
Good left hook there by Liam Smith, although Garcia tries to smile back at it. Another left hook there by Liam Smith.
Big left hook right there. That brought Garcia.
Yeah, Smith's most effective punch seems to have been that left hook, but there's still... Garcia said coming in, his style is I frustrate people.
Turning that punch, that's a perfect picture. Left hook right there. The elbow turned up and then turned down to turn.
Garcia right there, Garcia's trying to push.
And you notice that Garcia's not loading up either. That's also the reason that Smith is smiling. Maybe taking his round out, but still giving it away. Garcia getting confidence, coming forward and landing some shots. Not hard, but he's still landing the gloves on the face and the body.
You're right about taking
through this fight from the fifth round. Maybe Smith is taking this wrong out, but right there he hurt again. Garcia on the body. Same body shot.
It was that left hook. It looks textbook at this point.
Opens up the left hook to the face. And right there, Smith went for it.
Garcia, look, he almost winked at Smith. Liam Smith, the black gloves, wears autism on the trunk to support his younger sister, Holly. He talks so much about the Smith brothers, but
that's not the case anymore. Activity is one thing. There's that left hook that Joe Gallagher was talking about. You gotta get fighters like tough fighter power with direction and momentum, of course. Body shot right there by Smith. Double up on that side. Smith needs to double up on that side, and Garcia will submit. He's already been hurt to the body. We gotta... Here we see Beefy Smith with a left hook upstairs just to set up the shot he was intending to land with that body shot. Is it the trifecta of his demise? And by him, Liam Smith, they said. He's been showing that he's tough. He's landed some good shots, but it's been the Liam Smith show. Speed would be the key. And the demise of Garcia, I think if Liam Smith can concentrate on speed and get an angle.
50 seconds away from finishing the eighth round of the fight against Garcia.
Good shot there by Garcia on the inside. Trying to get a combination going right there, and Garcia caught him. Tried it again.
20 seconds left here, round number 8. Garcia's trainer predicted a knockout this round. Barring a miracle, we're going to be going to the 9th round.
This has never been stopped, Garcia. I think it's Smith is looking to go the distance now. He's not punching with a lot of... That's a veteran move there. Peeling down the guard just to come around with a Look, Fernando Vargas used to love doing that.
Pick him up, pick him up.
Sneaky, sneaky stuff.
Those Vargas Trinidad fights.
Who said more, though?
I kept Marvin's ready to make a call.
I kept the PG-13 there, man.
All right, 2.5 left here in the 10th and final round. Roberto Garcia and Liam Smith. Adnan Brooks, Sergio Mora, Lauren Gardner. Strong right as well. Going to the body again.
And it's Smith that's going for the knockout because he knows that Garcia's hurt to the body. I think Smith trying to get an angle on the tough Garcia. A high performance boxer, but, you know, right now, at 39 years old,
the distance.
And that's the reason fighters like Roberto Garcia will always have a job, even if they are 39 years old. Or really well, I would say. He's hurt Garcia on plenty of occasions, including right there to the body again, but he hasn't doubled up on any shots.
Oh, the distance. Both fights of the under. Every single second. Look at the smile there.
For your winner, by unanimous decision, from Liverpool, England, Liam B.B. Smith!
The highlights were all one-sided as far as the punching goes. As far as the heart and the will, it was evenly matched because Garcia wasn't going anywhere. Mutual respect by both fighters. I was really impressed with the body shots of Liam Smith. Fighting from the outside, the uppercuts were sneaky as well. Garcia kept smiling and taking them, continuing to find a way to win.
See if this one can end. It's halfway through the first round. Mahdi looking to make short work of Rakim's
knockout.
He took a decent shot from John that backed him up for a second, but
down he goes again. That wasn't much. Right hand to the head. Hook to the body.
Five.
Out of the round.
Seven. Eight. Nine. You went.
Strange knockdown.
I don't think that was a knockdown, but Johnson is reacting like it's a knockdown.
That is it. That's a knockdown. Fourth of the round. At that point, Soto says, I've seen enough.
Yeah, he was not behaving well. I mean, he got hit maybe in the back of the head. He kept reaching to the back of the head.
Great.
First one was easy to see and easy to register. There's nothing flukish about that.
First one was a beautiful body shot to the liver. That's going to be a hard punch to recover from, but credit to from Johnson getting up. Those are debilitating body shots right there, BK.
So now that's the second punch that we're wondering where it came from. It was really just kind of the back of the ear, the neck area. He slips the right hand here. And then that right hand looked like it didn't do much for that, but he was still complaining about getting hit, I guess, to the side of the head, and then the hook pushed him down.
It was a hook to the shoulder and bicep area that actually dropped Johnson, but he was shaking more.
Of 144 pounds, he comes in just over that weight, 144.3. He is a tall welterweight. He was very tall at 100. But man, that was outstanding. And it's the kind of fights you want to see. Hopefully, in 20 to Jeb in previous fights, he just waited to throw that big gun, that right hand.
He has an 80-inch reach, so we know he's facing
Perez. Here on a regular basis, Perez digs in a hook to the body. Now Hooker moves in, sensing he's got his man hurt, weakened, and the right hand, he drops Perez. Didn't take much. big early in this fight. You see that? Oh, it's over. Oh, maybe not. Moro down. Three. His head snapped.
Five.
Wow, that looked bad.
Seven.
That looked
eight.
Pretty.
Okay.
Body shot again. This might not last long. You got a minute and a half left in this first round. Moro in trouble again on the ropes. Ford showing the speed and the power. Said you gotta fight back at that point. Ford with. There's that right hook right there. That's the one that caught Moro's attention, that straight left hand. Wow. It kind of shades of Kovalev versus Canelo, right? The first shot Canelo hit Kovalev with, dropped his hands, and ran. The second shot was what put him out. Picture. Perfect. I say it all the time, Brian. Any southpaw with a right hook is always going to be dangerous. But look at that pretty left hand. And I can see why you thought it was over right there, BK, because the way that.
Rolled up, and the way he fell down to the ground, but the accumulation of speed was the demise of Moro right here against the ropes.
And if we can get Steve Smoker involved here, I just want to ask him about this stoppage, because it just felt, and look, it wasn't a lot of time, but it sure felt like it at the moment. Steve Smoker, referee, what do you think of that?
He could have gone in a little bit earlier, but the end was near.
But did you feel it was dangerous at that point, Steve? Like a few seconds too late, you thought it was all right?
No, I thought it was okay. You don't want to see it go any further, though, Bri. You're right.
Cesar Martinez, Christopher Rosales, this for the world title at 112 pounds. Martinez is 24, Rosales 25. We can use that leg to get a win tonight. See how quick he is already on the hook, Martinez. He should be lefty and righty simultaneously. Sergio, just moving the way he does, he's completely put
an entire round, southpaw, an entire round. Well, right-handed.
Unbelievable barrage. And then Edwards just went down on one knee. As he's, they exchange again. And Martinez sprung to the side.
Shots. He hurt the body, and yes, it went down. Yes, it was late, but it was in the heat of.
You can take a knee. Discretion is the better part of valor. He's used to seeing guys go down. They're on their nation there by Martinez. Goes to the body again. Rosales with a hook, but he eats a hook as well. Outstanding action in round. Good hook again by Martinez, and he follows up, and he gets his man hurt. He's exceedingly dangerous. Another hook. Rosales, though, wants to trade. Look at this. He says, bring it. Oh, good right hand by Rosales. That caught Martinez and drove him back. Savage minute in the beginning of round number two, and Martinez back to work with a beautiful combination, and he lands another hook. Rosales now.
Oh, Rosales can pop, looking for the counters as well.
Body shot and a combination there by Martinez. Another good body shot, digging to the bodies. Rosales is really taking control of this round with a stronger surge. I tell you what, there's a lot of shots landing from Martinez as well. There's no question. But the harder shots were from Rosales
with the right hook from the southpaw stance right there.
Action again in round three, slowed just a bit, and then Martinez went to work. Line war, Chris Maddox giving round three to Julio Cesar Martinez. Last time out again, that was ruled a no contest, but hard shots again. Martinez,
there's that right uppercut again, right? I'm telling you, it's a sneaky right uppercut. If he keeps, Rosales keeps getting hit with that, it's not going to be good.
Sometimes 5-7 in a row, body shot there by Rosales, and he lands a right hand. Blood as well from the nose of Rosales, and he's bloodied again. That snapped his head back. Hard body shot by Martinez.
And it's the outpour angle with the left uppercut.
Good body shot by Martinez. Rosales,
even though you can be aggressive, you're aggressive with feint as well.
Right hand landed, an uppercut landed. Martinez is landing with more and more regularity. Fires in now with another combo. Martinez is just relentless. Good uppercut by Rosales.
Yes, segundos.
Old school. Flyweight war.
And here's one of the many uppercuts that Martinez landed. There were sneaky uppercuts, but this one he landed as Rosales was pulling away, and that's what started the blood from the nose of Rosales.
Rounds that will let it all go.
I heard that. What are we talking about here?
Go
down on Rosales' part because of the counters, the fast counters of Martinez.
He did it right there too, Sergio. He went with the hook to the body, and now he's winging shots. Watch it on your own. He does it so fluently. See, now he's righty.
Gearbox will get confused there.
Gonzalez, the attack has slowed a bit. That was a hard body shot. Landed again. Feint right there. It's a heavy foot feint. You can tell that Martinez is not used to doing feints like that, but they're still working. Rosales ain't biting, but it's keeping him at bay.
Vicious body shots in combination for Martinez. About to get broken down. Starting to get beat up. Another good exchange for Martinez. His hands are just obscene for Martinez.
Good. Hoss is winning.
Oh, yeah, I do, too. I'm just, you have to be cognizant of close rounds. And when they swing, big punch.
He has a solid jab, but he's always looking for the big shots to the head, to the body.
A good hook and a straight right hand by Martinez, too. Look at that. He is creative in there as well. Using his imagination, using his skills, and using his viciousness as well. Another very good round.
And here we're going to see Martinez with that uppercut. He's been landing the entire fight. But this is what I mean right here, Brian. He's switching southpaw in the middle of the action right there. It's hard to combat that.
Yeah, sir. Who does that? Who else fights like this? I haven't seen anybody fight like this.
I know fighters that fight comfortably both sides, but he does it in between the action. That's just hard to stop.
It's part of his fluid attack is that he is driving forward, and he'll switch either way depending on where the openings are in this fight. Now there's Chris Maddox. Comes in with a yellow. Shading, and that means it's a close round, right? I thought Rosales did some nice work with the activity. Certainly Martinez continues to land the heavier shots, but a close between rounds.
Oh, that's a hard shot to the body again. That was right after a hook to the body, and Rosales looks like he has energy.
Trying to suck in some fumes here as he is taking more punishment. Has no choice.
And that upper body shot. That upper
again now, and he's spring-loaded. Unloading tough left jab since he switches back both ways. Up to the head, and Rosales looks hurt. He's bloodied. He's back in the corner. Martinez is looking very closely now at a possible stoppage right hand to the head of Rosales. Martinez, final seconds, hard hook lands for Martinez. Rosales tries to fire back with one.
Here we see Martinez coming around the guard of Rosales every shot with bad intention, and that's the reason the corner and the referee are starting to take a close look at Rosales. These shots are hard shots around the guard. That left uppercut right there, left hook. Those are vicious shots right there, guys.
Sergio, I don't think that Rosales' corner is taking that close a look at him. I thought I heard you're winning.
Where he's at.
And the first line of defense is his own corner, Chris, to your point. The corner should actually be looking...
Box no Dazon. Você pode fazer comentário, você pode fazer pergunta. Quer aproveitar, tirar dúvida, você de repente treina box?
On that type of punch, that's going to change the outcome of this fight. It's a good point. Good point. Another barrage there by Martinez, who has plenty left in the tank.
That sneaky uppercut again, in between the shots of Rosales as he landed punches on his own.
Martinez willing to take a closer look, maybe eat a shot to land one of his own, and maybe end this here in round 8.
Round for Rosales, actually.
Just had a little bit here. Chris Maddox giving Rosales that 8th round, but shading it in the yellow, and that indicates that a judge climbs soon, however. Rosales, nice combination. Able to establish, presenting a different look. Good hard body shot. Rosales looks hurt looking. And that's it. Raul Pais says that the end could come at any time. Hard body work. Martinez comes in and then goes to the head. That's 6-7 punches, Sergio. Right there.
And every shot with bad intentions. It wasn't like he was setting up. Martinez wasn't setting up. He was swinging away from the fences with every punch landing.
You know, it's not even a combination. It's a barrage. It's a fusillade.
It's an onslaught. It's combination at its best, Brian. And every shot was landed with mean intentions, especially the body punches.
And he senses openings. Where the opening is, he gets to. Look, it's not a title fight. They can weigh whatever they contract. And again, some money was taken out of $1 million taken out of the purse from Chavez Jr. as he comes in 5 pounds overweight. So there are the official weights.
Cut him up, bang at the bell.
It's a starched cue, Sergio. So it's been a while. Chavez, he can out jab Danny Jacobs. He tries with a big hook. Enough to kind of warrant these types of opportunities continuing to be thrown his way. Chavez Lozano was on this fight card as a fallback position. And I think all those things are certainly true. I do think what else is true is that Jacobs knows he's in line for Callum Smith or Billy Joe Saunders. And I think part of him did want to test himself.
Right hand and a hook by Chavez as he comes in. And there's Chavez Jr.
Listen, I just have not been the same guy that right hand. Hey, no question. Same thing we're talking about with Maurice Hooker. That hook just lands in. Maurice Hooker, if you say, hey, go to 147, well, you're going to be fighting some real stars, full-size stars. Weight is that he did weigh 172.7, but he had to work to get to 172.7. Where Jacobs weighs Jacobs landing shots like that.
Jacobs doesn't have a stronger jab, but he has a smarter and faster jab.
Two shots landed to the body. Those are scoring blows. Right hand landed from Chavez. At the time, I thought Canelo was winning rounds going away, and Jacobs really didn't get into a great rhythm and dominate on any stretch in that fight.
So, Jacobs, touch him upstairs. Just land the body shots. That's been the game plan. Land the hard body shots. Invest in the body early. Slow down the bigger man. And at the end of the round, when the bigger man wants to come and get it back, extinguish it by holding
forward. A little more murmuring from the crowd now as Chavez is really just not throwing the shots.
Something, but just what a shame. I mean,